So before starting this video, guys, here I am in the highway. Okay, so before giving you the life-saving lessons, highway driving lessons, so I just want to show you something here. So first, always comes the safety. Okay, so before you take your vehicle to the highway, make sure you are maintaining correct tire pressure and you are maintaining correct servicing of your car. Okay, so make sure you are giving 100% concentration on the road. Okay, so seat belt is a must for airbags to deploy here, friends. So make sure you are applying the seat belt. So as soon as you take your car to the highway, okay. And what are all the concentration degrading scenarios here? You can see. So when you are in a tension, when you are in a hurry, please don't drive, okay. And when you are ill, when you are sleepy, when you are tired, or when you are feeling dizziness, so I suggest you to not to drive. So don't make any phone calls, texting, or operating the phone while driving. So this could be seriously fatal to you. And if you really want to make phone calls while driving, so if there is so much emergency to you, then use the car Bluetooth system for connecting your mobile to the car, or use the Bluetooth earphones for making phone calls. And these days many cars come with touchscreen, friends, here. So I suggest you don't use the touchscreen while driving and watch the video while driving. Instead, use the steering mounted controls. You can see it here. There is a steering mounted controls here. You can use this for controlling the music, or if you want to receive your call from the phone or something like that, if you want to reduce the volume like that. Okay. And one more scenario is that, friends, here, don't talk much with the passengers. So this might seem funny to you people. So the reason why I'm telling this point is because it usually degrade your concentration if you are driving with the passengers and you are talking with the passengers and driving, okay? And don't drink and drive. This is the must point here, okay? And apart from this, please refresh yourself and take a break 1.5 hour once if you are going for a long drive. So eat, then drink water if you are taking the break 1.5 hour once, then wash your face, refresh, and then drive again. So these are the tips here, friends. You note it down. This will be really helpful for your highway driving. So here, friends, don't suddenly accelerate your vehicle. So I am moving my car from the stop now. You can see the speedometer here, it is at the zero. So I am just moving now. So what happens if you suddenly accelerate your vehicle? So it will really going to take a toll on your fuel economy, that is the mileage of your car. So steadily increase the speed of the car here like this, friends. So don't suddenly pump on the accelerator while driving. Like this, you suddenly increase the speed of your vehicle, friends. Don't suddenly pump on the accelerator. It will really going to give your take a toll on the mileage of your vehicle. If you encounter a divider like this, make sure you demand a bed the night. And if you are stopping your vehicle, don't suddenly brake the vehicle. So it will really going to take a toll on the fuel, that is the mileage of your vehicle. So slow down like this. Gradually you slow down. Then you stop like this gradually. So don't suddenly brake, friends, while driving. So the following vehicle, if any lorry or any car is following you, so it might come and hit you from the back. So that's a bad idea of sudden braking. So make sure you don't sudden brake when you are stopping, or if you encounter any oncoming traffic. So here friends, there is a scenario of overtaking from the left lane. Okay, so make sure you maintain enough space between the in front of your vehicle and your car. So turn on the left indicator here like this. So and see the rear view mirror to and make sure no vehicle is following you, and also see the side view mirrors. So then slowly come to the left here. And you see, make sure you are giving enough space between the slurry and your car, so that your left side of the wheels wheels of your car should be moving on the left lane mark of this highway. Now your friends, overtaking from the right lane. So here is a lorry in front of me. Make sure you are maintaining enough space between lorry and your car. And turn on the right indicator like this. Check out the side right mirrors. And check out the ORVMs here like this. And come to the right lane slowly. And make sure you are giving enough space between the left side of your car and this lorry like this. And don't move even very closely to the divider. So in the curve situation friends, here I am encountering a curve here. So don't overspeed your car in the curve scenario, and don't try to overtake any vehicle in the curve scenario. That will be fatal to you, since you are losing the centrifugal force and your car might crash. Okay, so in the curve scenario here, make sure you leave enough space between the divider and the right side of your car. Okay, don't move close to the divider. So and also make sure that your left wheels of the car are on the white mark here dividing these two lanes. Okay, so that will be very good. Or you can just come to the right side of the lane and you can move. That will be good idea. So in the curved scenario friends, why I told you to leave enough space between the divider and the right side of your car while you are making a right turn is because, so you don't know what is there in the oncoming road. When there is a right turn, you won't be able to see there. So if suddenly any animals or any person is standing near the divider, so you might crash him accordingly. So that's why I told you to give enough space between the divider and the right side of your car. So while making U-turn scenario friends, it's a U-turn scenario. So here is the U-turn. So I'm taking a U-turn here. First I switched on the parking lights, you can see it here. So and make sure no vehicle is following you there. So slowly slow down and stand in the middle of this one road like this, and make sure no vehicle is there. So and then completely turn the vehicle like this, and don't switch off the parking light soon after you make a U-turn. Why? Because you are still moving slow, so there might be a following traffic, so that they won't be able to recognize you are moving slow. Okay, so switch off the parking light soon after you pick up your car speed. Okay, so this is the U-turn scenario. While driving in a single lane friends here, so don't move very closely to the vehicle in front of you like this. So like this, don't move. Okay, so it will block the oncoming view or the oncoming vehicles which are coming from the opposite side. And don't ever try to overtake from the left side guys here. Okay, sorry, in the curve I'm saying, don't ever try to overtake from the curve here friends. So while overtaking from the in the single lane road guys, so maintain some at least 2 to 3 car distance between your car and the vehicle which is in front of you, so that while overtaking you can slightly come to the left here like this, and you can see if there are any vehicles. Okay, so don't move very closely like this. So it will completely block the oncoming traffic wheel. So apply some brakes and just check if there are any oncoming traffic here like this. So there is a traffic, you can see. So friends, in the night scenario, if you are overtaking like this, so make sure you make dim and dip like this some 2 to 3 times so that the lorry driver can recognize you. So later you can overtake. And also friends, if you encounter any divider like this, I am encountering a divider here like this. You can see some cycle is there. Make dim and dip. And be sure that you are maintaining sufficient distance between the divider near the U-turn and your car, okay? Also friends, while driving in the night, I recommend you to stay at the left lane if you are going in the two-lane road here. Why? Because in the night time, you can't see whatever comes from the divider, like an animal you might encounter suddenly if you are going in the right lane. And if by mistake some person is crossing, so you might crash, right? So stay at the left line if you are going in the two-lane road. And friends, while driving in the three-lane road during the night scenario or in the daytime scenario, so make sure you stay in the middle line, okay? So that you have enough time to react if any traffic comes or if any animal or if any person comes from the left or the right lane. So staying in the mid lane is always a safe idea. Friends, while driving at the night, so if you think if you're encountering any suspicious object while driving in the night time, so make sure you dim and dip like this 2 to 3 times so that you can identify if there is any object in front of you, then only you accelerate the vehicle. So dim and dip is a must while driving in the night. So also friends, if you are driving in the night, make sure you always drive with the high beam in the night time, okay? And what if you encounter suddenly a hump or a pothole during the night? So it's uncommon actually, so you might encounter, okay? So what to do at that time? So if you are going fast some 100 kilometers like this on the right lane, like what I am going, so suddenly if you encounter or any humps like this, there will be a signal, right? So make sure you watch those signals and turn on the parking light like this and make sure there is no vehicle on the left or on the rear view mirror and gradually come to left lane like this and you slow down and then you cross the humps and then you accelerate. So why parking light during the humps and why coming to the left lane? Because so the following vehicle which is following you might not know whether there is a humps in front of you. So he might come and collide you from the back, right? So that is why always you make sure turn on parking.